These shelves came with the house and they're kind of wobbly, and I didn't really want to bolt them to the walls, so I'm going to use parts of these shelves to make something sturdier and a little bit deeper.
Usable materials extracted.
I don't want to attach these with bolts like this because that was just wobbly. So I was thinking a support underneath like this, and then I realized if I put the support under here, because there's a ledge here, like this, I can put a shelf on either side of it. Plus I have plenty of width left to make the shelves wider.
Now I need to join these pieces into frames like this. And for that, I'm using double mortise and tenon joints. I'm cutting the double mortise using my slot mortising machine, and the double tenon using a double tenon template on my panter rotor. I just cut 64 more mortises, plus the 16 mortises I already cut in here. Here's my double tenon template, and these two are 13/8 of an inch apart, and with a 2 mm reduction that results in 2 tenons that are 13/16 of an inch apart, just how I cut the mortises. And these are 1/2 inch wide to reflect the fact that I need 1/4 inch wide tenons, and I'm using a 1 inch follower with a 1/2 inch cutter bit. And I drilled a hole in the middle of this template so I can just stick a pin in here. So this bit is on there, centered in this direction, and centered this way, so I know my tenons are going to come out roughly centered. That was a bit of a tight fit, so I'm going to back this follower up a little bit, which will make for slightly smaller tenons. That's better. Those double mortise and tenon joints have plenty of strength against racking.
So this is 2/3 of one of these shelves, which fills up the remaining width here. Well, that shelf took a while to load up, but now I'm one small step closer to being organized.
I made a total of 5 of those ladders, and 2 of those made another shelf.